Hello everybody, it's Lurgs here. Welcome to my channel. I'm here to save you time and money. And today, it's the iOS iMovie app on your iPhone or your iPad. Now, there are some amazing functions in iOS iMovie, but I'm just going to take you through slow motion, zoom, transitions, and some basic editing. Right, I'm on my iPhone here, so let's just go into the iMovie app and start a new project. So just click on the big plus sign, start a movie project, and then select the video file that you want. You can select multiple files. I'm just going to select one. This is a video of some local surfing. And what I want to be able to do is I want to be able to split this up, turn it into some slow motion, and also zoom in as well, and also adjust the volume. Now you can use your finger to just slide through the video, and then once you're at a specific point, now if you just tap the video on the timeline at the bottom, it will put a yellow border around it. This means it is now available for editing. Now there's a very easy way to shorten clips. You can just click on the video on the timeline and then you've got the yellow border around it. Then you can just put your finger on the beginning or the end of the video and you can just drag that in or outwards and that will shorten or lengthen the clip. Now I'm just going to put it back to how it was. And the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to split the video. I've now split this video into two clips, and now if I select the second clip, and at the bottom, if I select this stopwatch here, I can actually select the speed. So I'm going to scroll it down to half speed. So this is 50%. Now if I press play, you'll see that it's doing a nice bit of 50% of slow motion. But the footage is still quite far away, so I just want to zoom in. Now with that video clip selected at the top, you've got this magnifying glass icon. Just click on that and then basically put your two fingers on the screen and you can just pinch outwards and zoom in. Obviously, the further you zoom in, the lower the quality. Now it's slightly off center still, so I'm going to click on the zoom function again and just make it central. And there we go. And there's a link above now about how to transfer voice memos from your iPhone to your computer or laptop. Now I don't really need the last 3 or 4 seconds of this video, so what you can do is highlight this video and at the bottom click on the scissors icon and then click on split. And now if you click on the delete option with that clip highlighted, it will actually delete that clip. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to add my logo to the beginning of this footage. So I'm going to my photo album, adding a photo at the beginning. Because this is a photo, it will do a Ken Burns enabled kind of zoom feature. I don't want that, so I'm just going to deselect that at the top there. Depending on how long you want it, again, you can just click on it with your finger and just drag the right hand side inwards just to make it shorter. And this is the transition effect between scenes. So let's try fade. So it's going to fade out and then go to the next scene. I don't particularly like that. So just select that transition again. I'm going to click on dissolve. This is generally the best version. And it's dissolving into that next scene. I don't want to dissolve on slow motion because that's the same bit of footage. Now if you select this video timeline again, you can lower the sound. Because it's slow motion, the sound will sound a bit odd because obviously the sound is slowed down as well. So you can just either mute that completely or just make it a lot quieter. Now you can add music, just make sure that it's copyright free. iMovie does supply a few free tunes. Now I'm happy with all this footage. Click on done at the top. And then at the bottom, click on this icon here. Then you can send it to YouTube or Facebook, but I'm just going to click on save video. Now, if it's a 60 frames per second video, you can actually select that and save it as that. And there's a link above now about how to do that. So now I'm just exporting this movie. So now it's in my photo library. So if I go to photos, There it is at the bottom. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to transfer it to the computer, and now let's watch the final product. Now I think that looks absolutely fantastic. Because I videoed this footage at 60 frames per second, when you actually slow it down, it still remains really good quality. Obviously it's getting a bit grainier because I've zoomed right in, but I think that's a really nice effect. If you would like more how-tos on how to save you time and money, then please press the subscribe button down here. I really do appreciate you visiting my channel, everyone. If you'd like to select any other videos around here, that would be really cool. And be sure to hit that bell notification tab.